Baltimore police enforce curfew. Police fired gas to enforce a curfew on the streets of Baltimore, a night after violence and arson rocked the city. After an evening of largely peaceful protests, a few hundred people defied the deadline of 2200 hours 3 o'clock BST. But in the face of thousands of troops on the city streets, the remaining crowds later dispersed and police said the curfew was working. The protests have gone on daily since the death of Freddie Gray in police custody on April 19. His death is the latest in a string of high-profile cases where black men have died after contact with the police. There was an outbreak of violence after his funeral on Monday, but a different atmosphere characterized the streets the following night. The BBC's Tara McKelvey, at East Lexington and North Gay Street, said there was a street party feel with music and car horns sounding dong 2 hours after the start of the curfew, which runs from 2200 to 0500. Baltimore Police Commissioner Anthony Batts said it was working well. There were no major issues and only 10 arrests, he said. A few individuals threw bottles and gas canisters at police, but there were no major clashes. The National Guard had been sent to Baltimore to stop unrest for the first time since 1968, when some of the city's neighborhoods went up in flames after the assassination of the Reverend Martin Luther King Jr. City leaders and pastors had urged calm on Tuesday, after about 200 people were arrested the previous night as more than 100 cars were set alight and 15 buildings destroyed. The mother, who was filmed smacking her rioting son, instantly becoming an overnight celebrity, has spoken out about her widely praised actions. "He knew he was in trouble," Toya Graham told CBS News. "I'm a no-tolerant mother. Everybody that knows me knows I don't play that."